G'day, visiting the wonderful Mount Barney, and today heading up to Isolated Peak. I'm looking at the northeast ridge, trying to get up onto the shoulder section, and also hopefully get some footage of the route through the forest here. I've come in from the Lower Portals car park, and I'm heading to Rocky Creek, which is the first creek crossing along the trail. Just entering the bed of Rocky Creek. The track heads up that way. I'm going to walk up the creek. To get to the ridge that leads to Isolated Peak, I'm going to walk up Rocky Creek for a short distance until I reach a junction of two creeks. These are the bluff walls near the junction. It's nice to see the creek flowing, although the water's fairly impure. There's a lot of slime. This is the line of Rocky Creek, and I've come in from further downstream at the Lower Portals Trail. I've gotten to this junction in the creeks, and I'm intending to follow this ridge crest as it eventually leads up to Isolated Peak. The ridge runs in an arc directly to the northeastern ridge of Isolated Peak. This is also seen in this view from the northeastern ridge. We can see that an uninterrupted ridge line leads from Rocky Creek to here. It's worth mentioning that this is a large forested catchment area for all the waters on this side of East Peak, although there's very little surface water. The catchment is hemmed in by the line of hills in the middle distance. Isolated Peak also has a southeastern ridge, which begins in bushland about halfway along the approach ridge. Here's the line of hills from my present position in Rocky Creek. This is the junction. This section runs up for about 2 kilometers. Navigation can be a little bit difficult on this ridge. We can cross this four-wheel drive track along the way. It leads up to the Lower Portals Trail, and a flat shady section down that way. Past that first little knoll, now it's open grassland and grass trees in this section. It's a fairly broad ridge and it kind of curves over to the mountain. It leans over to the left on the way up and to the right on the way back. See, ridge headed to the left. isolated peak is over there. That's looking good. I'm headed the right way. After about a kilometer, the ridge is heading directly for Isolated Peak. Another thing for a bearing is this main creek bed just here. The ridge is running right alongside it. Approaching another little rocky step. How's this old fence line here? After the long flat ridge line, a steep incline leads towards the mountain. In this somewhat chopped off view of the mountain, we can see up onto the northeast ridge, and on the left is the southeast. This strange lone rock must have rolled off the mountain. Here's the base of the mountain. Doesn't look like I can go straight up though, the walls are too sheer. Gonna try and go around to the left. Now the terrain becomes much more difficult. Not able to go up until a fair way left. I'll climb these slabs. I'm going to go up here, try and get around the left of this bluff. This looks like a possibility. I have to be careful now to choose the right approach. The slabs are slippery with gravel. Should be able to step up through there. Quite difficult to walk about here. The slabs are just leaning downward everywhere, and the very rocks themselves are all just slanting downwards, ready to slide. You can see the burn off in progress over there. There's the southeast ridge. If I can get up here, I'll try and go up and over there. Okay, got through on the step. It's led me up to this wall. I'm gonna try and cross that ledge and make it up to the ridge line. The end of the ledge requires a pendulum move. Yes, I've made the ridge line, the northeast ridge. Once on the ridge line, it's only a short climb to the shoulder. This will probably be my high point today. It's getting late. Oh, finally some food. I'm starving. Such hard yak around here. On this side we can see over to East Peak, which is looking really broad from this angle. And on this side we look on to the southeast ridge of Tom's Tum. The southeast ridge of Tom's Tum is another uninterrupted ridgeline, and it leads up from the lower Portals Trail. Unfortunately, the bluff end at Tom's Tum is quite difficult to get onto. And as for Isolated Peak, I climbed this ridge in the early 2000s, and the first section is a really enjoyable exposed razorback climb, but the section at the top completely freaked me out. Send the drone up for a look and I'll explain. There are three places on the mountain that give me shivers when I think about them, and this is one of them. And I give fair warning that for a bushwalker, this is a serious undertaking. The upper section is first begun by climbing through this crack. Beyond there is a steep and slippery open chimney where the angles of the rocks are very disconcerting. I made it about halfway up before I realized that it might be beyond me, but I couldn't get back down because it was far too dangerous. I had to continue the ascent, and I did make it to the top, but it took me way out of my comfort zone. Here we can see down the access ridge. I'll return the same way I came in. Okay, I'm gonna head down now. cairn. Signs of people. Yep, that's the way down. Back at this ledge. Whoa, how weird. Looks like a footstep etched in the granite. I pause briefly beneath this slab overhang. This is about as good as it gets for shelter around here. Bit lower now, but again looking down the line of the access ridge. Occasionally get these slabs that have got a piece flaked off. They sound like ceramic or something. Heading down. Thinking this is maybe the only way up this bluff. The other side's very sheer. I think I might start traversing now. Man, I think I'm gonna have to cross lower. Going lower. Yes, I'm back at the base of the mountain, and I still think the right-hand side is harder than the left, even though the left was definitely no picnic. Now for the 2 kilometer bushwalk. These channels are left after large fallen trees have burnt away. The fires were very widespread. I mean, some of them really big fires. There are all these piles of ash here. On the other side of this creek on my right is the southeastern ridge. This is really unusual. I've seen this in here before. It's kind of like fresh dung. It looks like a cow pad, I guess. Horses, I guess. Unless it's yowies. Must be a herd of them in here. See how this ridge gets quite enclosed. Can't really see out. The most important thing is not to cross left or right through any gullies. Here's a rock and a clearing. I'll use the drone for the last time today. The ridge has turned to the left now, and I can see the bluff walls, the line of Rocky Creek. Mount Maroon helps with guidance too. Ah, here's an old favourite. I remember this from years ago. This is where the echidnas go in. Here's the four-wheel drive track. There are the bluffs. This is the junction. Now just have to walk the creek. Yes, I've made it back to the portals trail. My legs are exhausted and they're stumbling. Such rough terrain out there. But despite that, it was a great day. I love it out there. After my legs have recuperated, I'll go out again, this time to the southeast ridge. So that's the recce, and I'm approaching the car park now, so I'll sign out here. That's it from me. See ya.